Hello and welcome to a primer on organic chemistry from the perspective of the enormous versatility of carbon and its extraordinary potential to create novel compounds. There is something very interesting about all the different molecules that exist on Earth, which is that the vast majority of them contain carbon. Why? This video looks at carbon's unique properties that give carbon its versatility with bonding and thus its enormous potential to create novel compounds both biologically and synthetically. Something extremely important to remember is that we call compounds that contain carbon organic compounds. In this video, we will see what makes the carbon atom so versatile, examples of the many types of organic compounds, a primer on organic skeletal structures, and a bit of organic naming, all of which will answer our overarching question, why do the vast majority of molecules on Earth contain carbon? One of the first tenets of understanding organic structure is that carbon always has four bonds, something you will notice throughout this video. Carbon's amazing versatility is that it bonds to a large variety of other elements, including itself. Let's see how many different compounds we can make by bonding various atoms around just two carbon atoms. When all bonds are saturated with hydrogen, we have ethane, a common component of natural gas. Here, with ethene, we demonstrate carbon's further bonding versatility with double bonding, and the polymerization of ethene gives us a huge variety of plastics made from polyethylene. And carbon can also triple bond. This is ethyne, the gas used in acetylene torches used in welding and other applications requiring a lot of heat. An important point to consider here is our earlier statement that carbon always has four bonds. Each dash represents a bond, a pair of electrons, and so whether carbon is entirely single bonded or has a double bond or a triple bond, there are still a total of four bonds, four electron pairs around the carbon. Let's go back to ethane and see what else we can get with just two carbons. We can keep adding fluorines each time, creating a new molecule with new properties, or chlorine. And here we have a class of compounds called chlorofluorocarbons, which have a variety of uses, including refrigerants and aerosols, but which are also the source of much pollution. Back to ethane again to demonstrate something very interesting. We can substitute groups of atoms for a hydrogen, which vastly extends the properties we can get from our two carbon example. Any alcohol has the OH or hydroxyl group, which makes ethanol, something that people actually put in their bodies. And here we see the simplicity of naming schemes in organic chemistry. For ethanol, the first part of the name comes from the ethane that we attached the OH group to, and the OL comes from the classification of this type of molecule. It is an alcohol. This is the aldehyde group. You may have heard of the preservative formaldehyde. This molecule is called acetaldehyde. Organic acids, also known as carboxylic acids, are attached to a very wide range of carbon structures. This one is acetic acid, which is the acid found in vinegar. NO2 is the nitro group found in most explosives. And here's the amine group, which when coupled to an organic acid group on the other side, creates the amino acid glycine. I hope you can see from this structure where the term amino acid derives. All amino acids have this basic structure, only differing by what groups of atoms are displacing one of the hydrogens, which are designated with the letter R. And thiols play a large part in protein folding when they are present in peptide chains. Okay, so we've made 18 different organic compounds at this point just by changing the amount of bonds between the carbons or by substituting other atoms or groups of atoms for hydrogen. I hope you can see this is just the tip of the iceberg for only two carbons. Let's go back to our original molecule to see the many other things that carbon can do and how we can represent increasing complexity by creating what are called skeletal structures. Carbon can keep adding to itself, and this property is called concatenation, the ability to create long chains. Carbon can also branch off of itself, and this is called, can you guess? Yes, it is called branching. And carbon can close those chains into ring structures. As our molecules become more complex, it is extremely important to understand the shorthand, called skeletal structures, used to represent these molecules. Before we get to skeletal structures, however, we have to remember that carbon forms bonds at approximately 109 degrees. by showing that here we can now see from where the zigzag line of the skeletal structure derives, which is simply a line that marks where all the carbons would be if shown. The zigzag line, as the carbon chain itself, would exist in the plane of the screen. For any carbon at any vertex of the skeletal structure, two of the four bonds are shown, which are in the plane of the screen. And for the implied hydrogens, one would be bonded above the plane of the screen, shown by the solid triangle, the other hydrogen bonded below the plane of the screen, shown by the bond made of dashes. The skeletal structure assumes the presence of these hydrogens, but for convenience, they are not shown. The addition of a parallel line indicates a double bond, and ring structures can be easily shown. Let's see some examples of molecules using a skeletal structure, which hopefully will give you a better idea of the enormous range of organic molecules. Let's start with butane. Each vertex and endpoint represents a carbon, and hydrogens are implied but not shown, but this is where they would be given our understanding that each carbon has four bonds. Butane is a common fuel found in lighters. This is the vitamin A molecule, and the skeletal structure gives us access to the arrangement of a large amount of atoms. Oleic acid is oil found in olives, and it is an acid due to the organic acid group shown here. The structures of one of the estrogens, estradiol, and testosterone can be easily compared using skeletal structures. They are almost identical with the exception of those atoms seen here in blue and red. Both of these molecules are synthesized from cholesterol in the bodies of both sexes. We can also begin to see here the process of naming organic compounds. There are two alcohol side groups designated with the suffix OL, thus the derivation diol. Testosterone has the organic ketone side group, which is reflected in the name testosterone. Ring structures hugely extend carbon's versatility. A six-carbon ring gives us cyclohexane, benzene, phenol, and toluene for starters. If we add three nitro groups to the toluene, we get trinitrotoluene, otherwise known as TNT, a powerful explosive. Five-carbon rings are also prevalent, and if we substitute nitrogen at four of the carbon's vertices, we get this extremely ancient structure called purine. Purines have been around since the earliest life forms on Earth, and it is the precursor to many other molecules such as the DNA base guanine, which incidentally is a component of guano or seabird poop, and thus its name guanine. Caffeine is another example of many purines that are biologically synthesized. Carbon's versatility in bonding means it can be used to build extremely large molecules, such as the protein insulin with 778 atoms, or the protein hemoglobin with 9,336 atoms. Bonding with metals again expands carbon's versatility, such as heme, where iron binds to nitrogen in a carbon-based structure used to bind oxygen in hemoglobin, or dimethyl zinc, in which carbon bonds directly to the metal. DNA is the largest known molecule, with more than a billion atoms in the DNA of a single human chromosome. So why are most compounds organic? Carbon can form an amazing variety of compounds due to forming four bonds, including double and triple bonds, bonding to both itself and many other elements, forming chains and a huge variety of structures. These properties are unique to carbon, and there are an estimated 10 to the 40th possible compounds containing up to only 50 atoms. Just think of how large that number grows with more than 50 atoms. This has been a Mad Scientist production. See ya!